Hello students, good morning everyone. I am going to explain experiment number 3. Here object or aim is to determine the value of g, means acceleration due to gravity of the earth in the laboratory itself using a simple pendulum. Now for this experiment we need apparatus. Apparatus are a heavy metallic bob provided with a hook. Through this hook, we will be using a string to tie it, a string, a stopwatch, a retort stand, and a meter scale. Now let's go to theory. Here, theory, we will see T is equal to 2 pi under root over L by G. T means time period. So time period equals to 2 pi under root L by G, where L is the effective length and G is the acceleration due to gravity. It is clear from this formula that the square of time period is directly proportional to the effective length. That means T square is directly proportional to effective length. So a graph plotted between T square and L is a straight line. And from this straight line, we can get the slope S equals to 4 pi square by G. This portion, we will see how to calculate from the graph after plotting the graph later on. So, from here, we can easily get the value of G by using the formula 4 pi square upon slope of graph plotted T square by L. Only we need to know the slope of the graph, which I'll discuss or I'll determine later on. Have a look the diagram. If you look at the diagram, here P is the point of suspension. From this point of suspension till the mid of the bob is so called effective length L. And when the bob is pushed in one of the sides, say left side, by 5 cm, then an angular difference will create here 3 to 4 degree. And then when you leave this bob here, then the bob itself starts to move to and fro. Okay? It will starts to move, or better to say, it will starts to oscillate to and fro. So if you start from here, and then the bob will go to mean position, from the mean position to another extreme position, from this extreme position to again mean position, again it will come back to its own position. So when it comes back to its own position, then only you can say it is one complete oscillation. Like that complete oscillation, we will be counting for 20 to 30 oscillations to calculate the time period. Okay, for the first observation, let us take the effective length 70 cm. Right, okay. Now, this effective length 70 cm will be used to find the time period. Now, for time period, push the bob in one of the side 5 to 6 cm. And to record the time duration for 20 oscillations, we have to do both the things together. Means I'll leave the bob as well as I'll start the stopwatch. Okay, have a look. I'm leaving the bob and starting the stopwatch together so that we can get the time duration for 20 oscillations. Okay, let me start. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. And we have noticed here the The time was here 34 seconds. For second observation, we'll take the effective length 80 centimeter. Okay. Now we'll do the same. We'll see the time duration or duration of time for 20 oscillations, and then if we do for 20 oscillations, after doing 20 oscillations, we have noticed it takes for 20 oscillations 36 seconds. So here time period will be 36 divided by 20. For the first observation, as I told you before, we have taken effective length 70 centimeter, and that time the duration of time for 20 complete oscillation was 34 seconds. So time period equals to capital T, means T small t by 20. So 34 by 20 equals to 1.7 second. And now we have to plot this y. So when we get the value of y, means 1.7 whole square, we got here 2.89. Similarly, for 80 centimeter, 90 centimeter, 100 centimeter, and for 110 centimeter, we'll see the calculation and the values of y will be 3.24, 3.61, 4.00, 4.41 respectively. When we plot all the information on the graph paper, we have noticed a straight line can be drawn through passing through all the points. Okay, now to calculate the slope, we need the difference of y value, means delta y. Delta y is equal to y2 minus y1. This is y2, this is y1. So delta y is equal to 1.25. And for delta x, it is x2. This value is x2 and this value is x1. So delta x is equal to 105 minus 75 is equal to 30. Now we have to use this information, delta y and delta x, to find the slope. Okay, let's go for calculation. For slope, we have to use delta y by delta x. As I told you before, y2 minus y1 upon x2 minus x1, put the values of all, and we got here, it is 0.041. Now, at the last, we will go for calculation of acceleration due to gravity, g equals to 4 pi square by 100 into s. Putting the value of all, we got here 3.61 meters second inverse 2. Let me talk about why do we put this factor 100. Here we have taken the effective length in centimeter. So to convert that centimeter into meter, we have to divide by 100. Now here the value of g, we got 9.61 meters second inverse 2. As we know that the acceleration due to gravity on the surface of the earth is 9.87 meters second inverse 2. Then why is it a little bit less? Because we are above the ground level, above the sea level, means on the top of Himalayan.